Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Hello, Jennifer. Good evening. Good to see you there. How are you?
All right, teacher.
All right. Tired?
Solo el sueño. Okay.
Me imagino. Ya el último día ya se siente, ¿verdad?
Demasiado. Pero y... ya voy a encender la luz para esta clase.
Ay, sí. Pero no han estado mucho en evaluaciones. Que eso es cuando más, ¿verdad?
Justo se cerraba el sistema, este tren. Entonces,
sí, es más complicado, ¿verdad?
Siguiendo todas las notas que hacían falta, los chicos que hacían falta. Se trata de conseguirlos, recuperarlos. Ahora.
Sí. Es lo que más cuesta quizás en el periodo, ¿verdad?
Sí, sí, justo fue el día que le dije yo que no es porque estábamos, pero...
Me imagino.
Ya contra el tiempo, porque a las 12 se cerraba y es complicado después.
Ah, sí, me imagino. Perfectamente lo entiendo. Okay, guys, good evening, everybody. Good to see you all. We are about to start, so let's just do something. We're just going to give some minutes for the others to join. And tell me, how was your day, guys? Did you have a very hard day, or was a normal one, or what did you do? Ilkar, tell me, what did you do? Did you go to the gym today?
Yes.
Yeah.
Every day, teacher.
Every day, okay, that's a lot. How do you handle?
Very tired.
Yeah,
very
tired. Yes.
Duele mucho.
Your muscle is gonna be bigger. Your muscles. Yes.
Dentro de poco me va a ver así.
No, pero está bueno hacer ejercicios, esto es muy bueno. Sí, okay, guys, let's start then with class. So I'm going to pass the attendance right, and whenever you listen your name, don't forget to say present. Okay, give me just a moment. We are in the middle of the month, right? I mean, of the course, right? Almost, guys, almost. Ya casi, ya casi. Y siempre vamos a seguir el próximo módulo. Siempre.
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Yes.
Always. Okay, that's good, guys.
That's for me, good. Yes. But the company.
Who knows?
Maybe no, plus.
En realidad yo pienso que más depende de nosotros. Ah, bueno, al menos en mi caso, más depende de mí, porque la empresa no incurre en ningún costo.
Sí, ¿verdad?
La formalidad de llenar documentos, que incluso yo hago todo eso para evitar allí que alguien diga que no, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Y por otro lado, pues solo es cumplir las reglas y estar ahí pendiente de mi parte.
Exacto, sí. No, de hecho, estos cursos así de inglés son bastante caros, si ustedes los cotizan así en otro lado, son bastante caros.
Sí, son bastante caros.
Sí, hay precios entre 60, 50, ya al mes, ya es otro gasto ese. Ok, pero sí, ya casi, guys, ya casi. Ok, I'm going to pass the attendance, guys, and don't forget to say present. Amilka?
Present.
Ok. Ángela? No? Let's see, Carlos? No? Daily? Daily? No? Okay, Eloisa? Eloisa? No? Okay. Hugo Alexander Castro? Castro? No? Ayala, are you there? Ayala, Hugo Ayala. Who is speaking?
Hugo Ayala.
Hugo Ayala, okay, got it, Ayala. Jennifer Noemi.
Present.
Okay, Jessica Beverly. Jessica? No? Okay, let's see. Jorge Elvir. Jorge Elmir.
Present.
Okay. And let's see, José Naúm Palacios. José Naúm Palacios. No. Okay, let's see. Mabel Hernández. Mabel Hernández. María Elena. Margot.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Margot. María Emelina, ya, ¿verdad? Naúm Asensio, Naúm Asensio. Naúm Asensio, no. Okay, Nancy Guadalupe. Nancy Guadalupe, no. Oscar Armando. Oscar Armando. Silvana Beatriz. Silvana Beatriz.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Okay. Good evening. Thank you. Vanessa Odeth. Vanessa Odeth.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Thank you, Vanessa. Let's see. Walter Antonio.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Thank you, Walter. Okay. Let's see. Jairo Vladimir. Jairo. Okay. Jairo. And Linda. Are you there, Linda? No, okay. So guys, let's go over the lesson. Tell me, what did we study yesterday? ¿Qué estudiamos ayer, guys? What did we study yesterday? Mm-hmm. What did we study yesterday?
Me recibí una llamada cuando estaba pasando lista, no sé si...
Vaya, daily, ahorita vamos, daily. Let's see, daily... Bye. Yeah. Yeah, daily. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome, daily. And okay, what did we study yesterday? We studied what, guys? We studied.
Mm-hmm. I remember. Hello.
Yes.
I remember we studied two has and have.
Okay, we study have.
Positive.
Two and has two, right?
Negative. Has, it has two.
Has two. The negative. Sorry, the negative, affirmative, positive, right? And questions, right?
Right.
Okay, so, guys, I want you to write an example of using a negative sentence. I need a negative sentence using the verb have to. And the subject is going to be my sister. So I need a negative sentence using the verb have to and the subject my sister.
My sister doesn't.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't have to drive car.
My sister, okay, muy bien, Okay, give me just a moment, guys. Aquí está. It doesn't have to drive to work. Okay, muy bien. La misma oración, guys, como pregunta, as a question. ¿Cómo sería as a question? The same sentence. Mm-hmm. As a question, the same sentence.
Does
my sister, or does she? Mm-hmm. That's my sister. Mm-hmm.
Have to drive at work to work.
Have to drive to work. Okay, very good. Okay, and what could be the answer, the two answers that we can have if we have that type of questions? What is the answer? ¿Qué tipo de respuesta podemos dar to that question?
Yes, she does.
She does?
No, she doesn't.
Yes, she does. Or we can say, no, she,
no, she doesn't.
Doesn't. Very good. No, she doesn't. Okay, very good. And as affirmative sentence, un ejemplo de affirmative sentence, ¿cómo sería, guys? Affirmative. Affirmative, guys. La misma oración, the same sentence. ¿Cómo la podemos hacer afirmativa?
My sister does.
Affirmative. My sister.
My sister has to drive.
There you go, Hugo. Has
my sister
to.
Has to
drive to work.
Drive to work. Very good. So these are the three statements that we studied yesterday, right? Using have to or has to. Okay. También, cuando ustedes ya vayan más avanzados, se van a dar cuenta que many Americans, por ejemplo, en vez de decir have to, vamos a escuchar, por ejemplo, decir que dicen have to. Pero es más que todo cuando ellos están como en la calle, entre amigos, dicen have to. I have to, ya es como algo más que...
¿Caliche?
Exacto, algo así, lo van a escuchar bastante esto. En canciones se dicen bastante have to. Ellos como que acortan bastante los verbos, las palabras las acortan bastante. Ok, guys. Let's continue. We are going to have a game. Vamos a tener un juego. We are going to practice what we study. Okay? So, let's see who wants to participate, guys. Who wants to do the first one? Lo que vamos a hacer es contestar, right? Las preguntas. Okay? Everybody's going to participate today. Okay, so who wants to be the first one? Volunteers?
Hello, teacher. Good evening. And Naum, I'm going to be the first one.
Okay, Naum. Perfect, Naum. Okay. So, I will ask the question and you answer. Are you a happy person, Naum?
As a person, I feel very happy.
Okay, as a person, I feel very happy. Okay, now, Naum, I want you to choose another person and you are going to ask the second question. Okay, let's go, Naum.
Okay, Jenny?
Hello, Naum.
Hello, is your father tall?
No, my father is not tall.
Okay.
Yes, no, he is not, right? He no, is not tall.
No, he's not.
Okay, very good. Okay, let's see, Jennifer, can you choose another person and ask question three, please?
Okay, busquemos la víctima. Eloisa. Okay, are your parents strict?
Yes.
Yes, they... Yes, they are.
Yes, they are, right? Are your parents strict? Yes, they are, or no, they aren't. Okay, very good, Elisa. Can you choose the next person, please, and ask question number seven? Question number seven.
Amilcar.
I was thinking about that person.
Good night. Are you a sportsman?
Yes, I am, but I try now.
Okay, yeah, that's the point, right? You keep working. Okay, Amilcar, could you choose the next participant, please, and ask the question? Question okay. Eight.
And my friend, Oscar.
Question six, okay.
Hi, Oscar.
Hello, Oscar.
Hi. Hello.
Are your friends good?
Are your friends good? Yeah, ¿cómo sería?
Yes.
They
aren't.
Yes, they are. Okay, yes, Oscar. Now it's your turn, Oscar. Can you choose another person and ask a question? Question five.
Boy. Maria. Maria Melina.
Okay, Oscar, I'm ready.
Seventh, number seven. Are you a sport?
Number five.
Yeah,
please.
Is the waiter Sonny known? No.
Now?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. No, it doesn't.
Mm, okay. No,
it is not.
Yes, yes, that's the answer. No, it is not. Okay, very good, okay. Melina. You choose the next person, please. Can you choose the next person? Question number four. That is a difficult question.
Okay, let me check for who is that question.
Mm-hmm.
Is George in class?
George? Yes, George is there.
Okay, the question is for George. Is your English teacher kind?
I'm listening carefully.
Okay.
That's who, George.
Yes, she is.
Okay, yes, she is. Okay. Glad for you, George. Excellent.
Thank you.
Okay, George, choose the next participant, please, the next volunteer.
The number eight?
It's going to be number, nine. Let's see, number 11. Number 11. Yeah.
Give me a moment.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Silvana.
Okay, Silvana.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hello. Hi. Is your mother a doctor?
No, she isn't a doctor.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Now choose another person, Silvana, please. And you're going to do question 10, please. You're going to ask question 10.
Daily.
Okay, daily.
And number
10.
No, not teacher, number 3.
Okay, go ahead. It's okay, Silvana.
Are your parents strip?
Mm-hmm.
No.
They.
Mm-hmm.
They no.
No, they aren't.
Okay.
Aren't. Oh, uh-huh.
Okay. Very good, Daily. Okay, very good. Thank you, guys. Okay, solo quiero, por ejemplo, con la pronunciación, guys, with the pronunciation, que hagamos esto bien. Con la palabra, por ejemplo, strict. El sonido es con la T, ¿verdad? Que significa estricto, ¿verdad? Pero si decimos, por ejemplo, strip, con el sonido de la P, se va a entender otra cosa. Así que tengamos cuidado con la pronunciación, ¿ok? Strip. Y tenemos strict. Okay. Strip es un verbo también, ¿verdad? Entonces tengamos cuidado with the pronunciation. Eso significa deshacer, ¿ok? Deshacer, strip. Ok, entonces take care with that. Ok, Okay, guys, let's continue. We're going to continue in the next class with these questions. Okay, let's go over the topic, guys. And today's lesson is going to be a review of the conferences that we have had this week. Vamos a hacer un review, un repaso de la unidad number two. ¿Qué estuvimos estudiando? El simple present, have to, need to, and has to, right? So we're going to have some practices related to that. Okay, I want you to answer this question, everybody, in the chat box, right? Okay, vamos a responder esto in the chat box. And let me ask you, do you mark your events in your calendar? Do you mark your events in your calendar, guys? Por ejemplo, tenemos ahora, with technology, we have the Google Calendar, right? Tenemos, por ejemplo, digital calendars. So, do you mark your events in your calendar? ¿Podemos escribir la respuesta en el chat box, guys, please? Do you mark your events in your calendar? Mm-hmm. What about you, Emelina? Do you mark your events in your calendar?
Yes, I do.
Yes, I do. Okay, it is so important, right? Okay, Amilcar, thank you. Okay, and the others, guys, let's see. Escribamos la respuesta. Mark, okay, you mark the events, right? Well, okay. I do all events. Okay, Vanessa says that she does. Hugo Castro too, right? Okay, do you attend the events, guys? ¿Ustedes van a los eventos? Are you in the events when you have, for example, the calendar? Do you go to the events? Do you attend the events? I guess maybe most of us, right? Sometimes, okay. Mika said sometimes. Okay, in the case that it is important, right? Okay, vamos a tener this a dialogue. It says, Adele. Adele, please check my agenda. When is the meeting with the consultant? On Monday, November 22nd. What about the conference with the Mexican representatives? It's on Friday, the 26th. Okay, that is the conversation. Questions about any word, guys? ¿Algunas preguntas, guys, acerca del new vocabulary? Questions, guys?
No, teacher.
No, we are good. Okay, let's read. Vamos a leer entonces the dialogue. Susan, you're going to be Vanessa. Yes, Vanessa. Usted va a ser Susan. Vamos a leer la parte de Susan, Vanessa. And Hugo Ayala is going to be Adele. Ready, guys?
Okay.
Hugo Alexander, ¿me ayudar, Hugo? Oh, perdón. Hugo, Hugo Alexander. Sí. Sí, Hugo.
Ready.
Okay, let's go. One, two, three. Let's go, Vanessa.
Adele, please check my agenda. When is the meeting with the consultant?
On Monday, November 22nd.
What about the conference with the Mexican representatives?
It's on Friday, the 25th.
Okay, perfect, guys. No problem. Okay, let's see. Hugo Ayala, please. You're going to be Susan and Adele is going to be Walter. Ready, Walter?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, let's go, Hugo Ayala, please.
Adele, please check my agenda. When is the meeting with the consultant?
On Monday, November
22nd.
22nd, thank you.
What about the conference with the Mexican representatives?
It's on Friday the 26th.
Okay, it's on Friday. Very good, Walter and Hugo. Okay, guys, let me ask you. When is Susan's meeting? ¿Cuándo es la reunión de Susan, guys? Escribamos la respuesta en el chat, please. Escribamos la respuesta de the question one and two. Can you write the answer, please, guys, in the chat box? The second question says, do you think Susan has a busy agenda? Why? Okay, when respondamos, guys, please, in the chat box. November 22nd, okay. La segunda respuesta, Walter, please. Second question. Okay, what about number two, guys? Do you think Susan has a busy agenda? Why? Why do you think she has a busy agenda? Okay, Eloisa, what about you, Eloisa? Do you think that Susan has a busy agenda and why? Eloisa, what about you, Eloisa?
What's the meaning busy?
Busy, ocupado. Okay. Do you think Susan has a busy agenda?
Yes, she has a busy agenda.
Okay, why? What do you think?
Because she has a lot of meetings.
Exactly, right? Because she has a lot of meetings. Very good. Okay. Siempre que veamos el why, guys, siempre que veamos el why, debemos de responder con un because, ¿verdad? Because she has a lot of meetings. Okay. Important. Okay. Siempre que tengamos why, significa por qué, pero es para pregunta, vamos a responder con un because. Okay. Because. En las películas, por ejemplo, vamos a ver que en vez de decir because, ellos ocupan cause, cause, de esa forma, o también de esta, cause. Es como una forma informal de decir because. ¿Ok? Ok, guys, let's continue. Let's continue. Vamos a ver este día un poco de how to write dates in English, right? Tenemos como two versions, right? Tenemos la British, la británica, and we have the American English. Para escribir las dates, right? Los días, dates, las fechas. Ok, en el caso que tengamos la version, the British version, lo vamos a escribir primero el día, el mes, y luego el año. Day, month, and year. Por ejemplo, 14th September 1971. Tenemos el día, el mes y el año. Este es para la forma escrita, ¿ok? Cuando estamos escribiendo, por ejemplo, correos, estamos escribiendo alguna carta, en ese caso vamos a escribirlo de esta forma, de la forma británica. ¿Ok? Ahora quiero que ustedes escribamos en el chat un ejemplo de esta forma, utilizando el día, el mes y el año. ¿Ok? Escribámoslo en el chat, guys, please. Ah, no, Oscar, necesita. You need to drink coffee. Yes, right? We need a cup of coffee.
Okay. Yes, the battery is long.
The battery is low, yes, exactly. Ok, escribamos el ejemplo, to guys, in the chat box. Ok, Walter, excellent. Ok, 15 September. Ok, Amilcar, vamos a ver aquí en su caso, ¿verdad? 10th March 1988. Ok. Ok, very good, guys. En el caso de cuando estamos hablando, guys, vamos a decir the más el número ordinal, que es lo que vamos a ver en la siguiente slide. Por ejemplo, the 14th, que sería este, of September 1971, en el caso que estamos hablando, when we are speaking. ¿Okay? Si tenemos, por ejemplo, la American version, la versión American, right? Vamos a escribir primero el mes, el día y luego el año. En la forma escrita, cuando estamos escribiendo, vamos a decir September 14th, 1971. ¿Ok? Y cuando estamos hablando, September da. No nos olvidemos del da, guys. Más el número ordinal. y el año, ¿verdad? No sé si hay dudas. Questions, guys, del orden.
No, teacher.
No, ok, we are good then. Okay, en el caso de las fechas, guys, como lo vimos en la slide anterior, vamos a utilizar los números ordinales, right? Ordinal numbers. Por ejemplo, primero, en español lo podemos decir como primero, segundo, tercero, cuarto. Entonces, primero, we're going to say first. Segundo, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, 20th, 21st, and so on. Eso lo vamos a utilizar siempre cuando estemos con las fechas, ¿ok? No sé si hay dudas with the ordinal numbers. Ok, let's continue. En el caso que estemos hablando de los años, lo podemos dividir. Podemos decir, por ejemplo, 1984, o lo podemos decir de la forma larga, ¿verdad? 1984. Ok, and basically that is the explanation of the dates. No sé si tengamos dudas, guys, questions. Ok.
¿Qué significa la TH?
Ok, la TH, lo vamos a encontrar en... Sí. La TH la vamos a encontrar en la mayoría de los números. Y esto nos da a entender que es un número ordinal. Por ejemplo, cuarto, quinto, sexto, séptimo. Eso es lo que nos da a entender que es un número ordinal. ¿Ok? ¿Ok? Entonces, that is like the main difference. Ok, vamos a hacer algo, guys. Vamos a escribir la fecha de este día using the American version on the chat box, please. Vamos a escribir la fecha, today's date, in the chat box. No nos olvidemos de usar the ordinal numbers, right? Terminación. No nos olvidemos de eso, ok, guys. Ok, aquí está, the American English version. Escribámoslo en el chat, guys, please. What date is today? What date is today? Ok, cuando estamos escribiendo, Silvana, primero sería el mes, luego el día y por último el año. Ok, Silvana. Ok, very good, Melina, excellent. Okay, let's see. July 2nd. Ok, Hugo, vamos a detenernos en esta, Hugo. Cuando es segundo, le vamos a agregar esta terminación, mire, Hugo. This one, ok. Second. Esa es la terminación, ok. Lo mismo para Hugo Ayala. Perdón, Hugo Ayala. And, vamos, también para Oscar, la terminación es ND, ok, guys. Esa es la terminación. Amilcar, también Amilcar, la terminación. Take care. Veamos, Hugo, what day is today? Hugo Castro, today is second, right?
Yeah, sí, me equivoqué, creí que era tres.
Ya pensando en el sábado, ¿verdad? Ok, let's see, Silvana, excellent. Eloisa, very good. Hugo Ayala, too, very good. Much better, yes. Siempre, guys, algo bien importante, los meses siempre van con capital letters, siempre van con mayúsculas. ¿Ok? Así que take care with that. Capital letters. ¿Ok? Very good, Marcos. Ok, Oscar, very good. Daily, excellent. Let's see, Jessica, too, very good. Ok, Vanessa, excellent. Hugo Castro, excellent. Okay, let's see. Okay, guys, ahora me van a escribir la fecha de su cumpleaños. When is your birthday? When is your birthday, guys? Okay, when is your birthday? Can you write it in the chat box, please? My birthday is on, let's see, May 3rd, okay? No voy a escribir el año, ¿verdad? Let's see, on. On May 3rd. This is a secret, a top secret, right? Let's see. Okay, it is on March 10th, 1982. Very specific, Carlos. Very specific. Okay, November 26th, 19. Ah, okay, I got it now. Okay, excellent.
Okay.
Let's see. Hugo says that it is on November 23rd, 19. Alexander, very specific, right? Okay, let's see. Amilcar says on May. May, okay. Okay, ¿cómo vamos a Amilcar? ¿Cuál es el orden? Y si es American, por ejemplo, Amilcar. If it is American, month, day, and year, okay?
70, 60.
Okay. You are British. You are British. Okay, that's fine. Okay, let's see. My birthday is on March 1st. Okay, Silvana, got it? My birthday is on December, and Jorge, period, okay. Daily, okay, let's see.
El antibiótico ahorita.
Okay, let's see, guys, si me ayudan con los micrófonos, guys.
Y después, perdón.
Okay, thank you, guys. Okay, let's continue. Tenemos daily, el daily lo hizo de la forma British, right? November 15, okay, my birthday, okay, very good, guys. Okay, do you have questions, guys, about the dates and everything like this? No questions? Siempre no nos olvidemos de los ordinal numbers, la terminación, okay? The ending, the ending. Okay, let's continue. Okay, guys, vamos a escribir entonces, we're going to write a name of the month and the activities that you will have in that month. For example, este mes de July. ¿Qué actividades vamos a hacer en este mes de July? Okay, por ejemplo, in my case, on July, let's see, on July, today is second, oh, on July 5th, I have to present my lessons. That is in my case, right? Okay, necesito tres actividades, seleccionamos el mes y escribimos las actividades que vamos a hacer para este mes. I have to present my lessons. Okay, what about you guys? Three sentences, okay? Three events, right? I got one. Okay, I'm gonna give you some minutes and then you present. También, guys, cuando damos alguna fecha, vamos a utilizar siempre on July, on September. Amilcar, in your sentence, they must be three sentences, right, Amilcar? Three sentences. Pero no veo la fecha, Amilcar. Solo dice el mes. On July, ¿qué? On July 19th, the 19th. On July, what? ¿Qué actividades tenemos para este mes, Amilcar? What activities do we have for this week? On a wedding. I don't know if you are going to be on a wedding. on July 3rd, I have to run, okay? Is that like a competition, Hugo, Alexander?
It's for my bienestar.
Oh, it is for my health, for mi salud, right? Sería health, health. It is for my health, okay? Para mí, salud también, ¿verdad? Si queremos decir también bienestar, bienestar, we can say well-being. Bienestar, well-being. It is for my well-being. Okay. So, let's see. Amilcar says on July 25th, okay, I leave, I have vacations, right? Amilcar, okay. I have vacations.
Yes. On July, I
celebrate my birthday. Okay, excellent. Very close, right? Vanessa, we're going to have a party. Okay, desde ya, felicitaciones. Okay, Vanessa, congratulations. Okay, let's see. Walter, on July 5th, I have to check a report. Okay, Walter, okay, got it. Let's see, on July 5th, I have to all... I have to take the first dosage, right? The first vaccine, okay? Vaccine. Una, we say vaccine, right? First, okay, the first vaccine, Emelina, in that case.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, it says now, on July 3rd, I have to pay the bills, right? And on August 6th, I have to celebrate my birthdays. Oh, your girlfriend's birthday. Excellent, Naomi. Excellent. That is a
great. Sure.
Yes, it's sure. An important event.
Yes, of course.
Of course, right?
Okay. If I forget,
you're going to be punished.
Yes.
Punish means? Yeah, okay, punish. Okay, you're going to be punished, right? I have to check my car on the 20th July for vacation, okay? July 3rd, okay, Daily, tengamos cuidado con 3rd, okay? Okay, Daily, sería, okay, así, 3rd, okay? On July 15th, I have to check a new app, okay? You're creating a new app, Carlos? Carlos, are you creating a new app? On September 21st, I have to go to a birthday friend. Okay, very good, guys. Let's continue. Vamos a hacer este listening entonces. No sé si hay dudas acerca de los dates. Questions about dates, guys? No questions? Okay, estamos bien entonces. Ya vimos la British date and we started the American date, okay? So, vamos a tener este listening, guys. And vamos a number picture from 1 to 4. Okay, vamos a escuchar el audio y vamos a enumerar la descripción, ¿verdad? Okay, let's listen.
Page 45, exercise 4, listening. It has just one room. Listen to four people describe their homes. Number the pictures from 1 to 4. 1.
My family lives on the first floor of a house. Another family lives on the second floor. The people on the second floor are nice, but they're not very quiet.
2.
I live in an apartment downtown. It's on the fifth floor of a large modern building. I have a great view of the city, and I'm close to lots of stores and restaurants.
3. My apartment is very small. It has just one room with a very small kitchen. It doesn't have a bedroom, so I sleep on the sofa.
4. My family and I live in an old house in the country. The house is a little small, but we have a nice yard and lots of trees. We like it a lot.
Page 45, Exercise 4, Listening. It has just one room. Listen to four people describe their homes. Number the pictures from 1 to 4. 1.
My family lives on the first floor of a house. Another family lives on the second floor. The people on the second floor are nice, but they're not very quiet.
2.
I live in an apartment downtown. It's on the fifth floor of a large modern building. I have a great view of the city, and I'm close to lots of stores and restaurants.
3. My apartment is very small. It has just one room with a very small kitchen. It doesn't have a bedroom, so I sleep on the sofa.
4. My family and I live in an old house in the country. The house is a little small, but we have a nice yard and lots of trees. We like it a lot.
One more time, guys. One more time. Or that's it?
That's it.
That's it? That's it. Okay.
The last one, please.
The last one. Okay, the last one. Okay, let's go.
Page 45, Exercise 4, Listening. It has just one room. Listen to four people describe their homes. Number the pictures from 1 to 4. 1.
My family lives on the first floor of a house. Another family lives on the second floor. The people on the second floor are nice, but they're not very quiet.
2.
I live in an apartment downtown. It's on the fifth floor of a large modern building. I have a great view of the city, and I'm close to lots of stores and restaurants.
3. My apartment is very small. It has just one room with a very small kitchen. It doesn't have a bedroom, so I sleep on the sofa.
4. My family and I live in an old house in the country. The house is a little small, but we have a nice yard and lots of trees. We like it a lot.
Okay, guys, so let's see who wants to do the first one, guys. What is the description of the first picture? Who can tell me some description of the first person describing their homes?
Okay, teacher, I'm going to try to.
Okay, let's go now. Yes, tell me. Tell me the description, please.
Okay, in the audio. The person who is talking is a man, and he said that they live with another family in the same house. The second family live in the second floor, and he said that they are very nice, but they are not quiet. And I had to do the answer, right?
Yeah, you have to.
Okay, for my view is the four picture.
The last one. Okay.
Yes. Of course.
That's right. That is going to be number one. Perfect. Now, thank you. Very good.
Okay.
Okay. Who wants to do number two, guys?
The number two is the building and the first one.
Okay, give me a description, Amilka.
The building very, very bigger.
Okay, and, it's bigger?
This very restaurant and apartment.
There are apartments and there are restaurants, okay?
UBK in downtown.
Okay, so what is the picture? Is the first one, second one, or third one? What is the picture?
First one.
Okay. The first one, right. So that is going to be the second description. Guys, díganme, teacher, too much English, too much Spanish. Let me know, guys. Okay. Am I too fast? Am I too slow? Tell me. Are we good?
Yes, we're good.
Yeah. Yes, guys, guys, or no? Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Jorge. Okay. So, guys, vamos con la number, picture number three. Who wants to do number three? La número tres, guys. Who says me?
George.
Okay, George, let's go, George. Tell me the description. Descriptions, okay?
She described the small department. I don't remember only this, but the picture is the number three.
Okay, I understand it is number three, this one, right? Okay, yes.
Teacher, I'm going to help you, my friend George.
Thank you.
About the description, right?
Yeah, right.
And she said that she lived in one room. It's very, the kitchen is very small, and she said that the room doesn't, the house doesn't have a bedroom, and she had to sleep in a sofa, yes.
Yes, perfect. Now I could notice that.
I'm sorry.
Yes, okay. Yes, now, right? Very okay, good. And the last one is this one, right? Number four. Por ejemplo, ese tipo de casa también, guys, se le conoce como cottage. También así le podemos decir como cottage.
Beautiful.
Yes, I would like to know their cottage. Son como casitas así en el campo, okay. That is so beautiful to live there.
Cabañas, teacher.
Cabañas. Permítame, me recuerdo. I don't remember, guys. Let me just check.
Cottage is equal cabañas?
It can be. I think it can be. Okay, let me check. Cabaña. I think it is the same as cottage.
Okay.
Okay. Cottage. Sí, se puede tomar así como cottage. Yeah.
My home is cottage.
Okay. Your house is a cottage.
So.
Okay, but that's beautiful, right? To live far from the city. That's
around many three.
Beautiful.
Yes. And I don't have many people around. And it's 6 p.m. I can sleep very well ¿cómo sería el siguiente día?
Next day.
And anyone problem to... ¿Ruido, cómo se dice, teacher?
Noise.
And sleep very well.
Okay, that's awesome, right? To have that life. Okay, very good. Thank you for sharing. Yes. Okay, thank you so much, Amilka, for sharing. Now, guys, all of us are going to work. Ahora sí, vamos a trabajar en la siguiente actividad que va a ser un speaking, right? And let me just share the activity.
Page 40.
¿Qué vamos a hacer, guys? Vamos a pensar en nuestra dream house. Si ya la tenemos, much better, right? Entonces, vamos a pensar en una dream house que nosotros quisiéramos tener. Por ejemplo, si es una loft. una loft que puede ser como like in a hotel, like there are like a lot of like places, let's say. Entonces, that depends, right? Podemos decir en una cabin también, una villa o una beach house. ¿De qué tipo de casa le guste? Podemos decir una cottage también. Entonces, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Vamos a pensar en esa dream house que nosotros quisiéramos o que ya tenemos. Vamos a elegir una imagen que esté relacionada con la casa que usted quiere, ¿verdad? Vamos a escribir un párrafo. La siguiente pregunta, por ejemplo, what is your dream home like? Where is it? What rooms does it have? What things are in the rooms? And does it have a view? Tenemos un ejemplo. My dream home is a loft in a big city. There is one large living room with a lot of windows. There are two bedrooms. There are two sofas. There are trees, etc. No sé si hay dudas, guys. Questions?
Yes, no comprendí mucho la idea. I'm sorry.
Okay, no problem, Walter. Okay, vamos a elegir, por ejemplo, una dream house que tengamos. No sé qué tipo de casa le gustaría a usted, Walter, o cuál es la casa de sus sueños, let's say.
Beach house, digamos.
Okay, is that in the city or far from the city? ¿Está en la ciudad o is it far? ¿O in the countryside? ¿Dónde está? Ok, entonces vamos a seleccionar una imagen, Walter, que esté relacionada a esa casa, ¿verdad? Después vamos a dar una descripción utilizando las preguntas que tenemos acá. Ok, this one, Walter. Ok. Tenemos un ejemplo. Okay. My dream house is, for example, is far from the city or is in the city. My house is in the beach, también podemos decir, right? Si en caso que queremos una casa in the beach. Ok. Questions, guys? No questions? No. Everything is good? Ok. Ok, entonces, how much time vamos a tener para esta actividad? Les voy a dar, son las, let me see. Ok, son las 9, guys, let's say. Vamos a pasar con las actividades a las 9:10, ok? Vamos a empezar con las actividades a las 9:10. 9:10, you are going to present. Ok, guys? Try to add as much information as you can. Van a presentar la imagen, don't forget that. You're going to explain. Okay, let's go, guys. Comparto la imagen in the chat too.
Individual teacher or in pairs?
Good question. It's going to be individual. Si podemos buscar la imagen, guys, y esa es la que vamos a describir, ¿ok? Don't forget to choose a picture. La podemos, we can copy the picture in a Word document, ¿ok? Podemos presentar la imagen en un documento Word. Ok, let's go, guys.
So
okay, guys, time is over. Who wants to do it first? Who wants to do it? Who wants to do it, guys? Who is ready? Or do you need more time?
More time?
Teacher.
Okay, what about if I give you 3 minutes? ¿Les parece bien si te estoy 3 minutes, 3 minutos, guys? 3 minutes?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Okay, guys, now, yes, time is over. Who wants to present, guys? Who is going to be the first one? ¿Quién quiere ser the first one, guys? Volunteers?
Me, teacher.
Okay, who says me? Walter. Okay, Walter, let's go. You can present, you can project your picture, Walter. Can you project it? Okay, beautiful. Okay, Walter, go ahead. I love that.
A ver si está bien, teacher, si capté la idea. My dream house is in the countryside, outside the city, with a large patio and open air, large rooms, a nice kitchen, and spacious living rooms. In the room there will be a lamp and the and a bathroom.
Okay, excellent. Hey, Walter, is that from, is your dream house related to Goku's cartoon?
Yes, teacher, yes.
Okay, that's good. Yes, I would say the same. Very good, excellent. Okay, thank you, Walter. Can you choose the next person? ¿Podemos elegir la siguiente persona, Walter, please?
Okay, vamos a ver. a ver. Amilcar.
Ay, sabía. Okay, teacher, I have two problems with the picture. Uh-huh. La compartí en el chat, en el WhatsApp.
Okay, let me see. Okay, let's see. Okay, got it. I'm gonna share it in my presentation, and then you can speak, okay?
Okay. My dream house.
Yeah, okay, give me just a moment. Okay, give me just a moment. I'm gonna share your dream house. And then you start explaining, okay? Let's go, Amilcar.
Okay. So my dream house is a big with many bedrooms, two floor, around many plants and flowers. It has two doors and windows. Someone, I don't know to say, teacher, terrazas.
Okay, let me check. Okay, continue. I will find the word.
Someone, terrazas. Okay. I love it to attend my family when they to visit me. I will your amphitheater for good way in this place. So my dream house, it has a big kitchen and many tables and chairs for to visit. There are salons.
Rooms,
okay. There are rooms for to do parties and events. I like to give welcome of my friends in the dream house. Always I can do it. My house is in a country.
Okay, is it in our country or in another country or outside, Amilcar?
A country in el campo.
A countryside, it is in the countryside. Está in El Salvador or in another country? Is it in El Salvador or in another country?
No, in Salvador.
Okay, for sure, right? Okay. Okay, Amilcar and Safran ask you for the word terraza, right? Okay, so in the chat, I'm gonna write it in the chat.
Uh-huh.
Okay, let's see. Okay, we can say that, for example, it can be flat roof, and also we can say terrace. Okay, that is the meaning. Okay, guys, do we have volunteers or should Amilcar choose some of you? Tenemos volunteers, guys. O Amilcar puede elegir el siguiente volunteer.
I choose.
Okay, veamos si no hay volunteers. Okay, Amilcar, let's see if there is no volunteer. You can choose.
Yo.
Who is me?
Oscar.
Okay, let's go, Oscar, please.
Ya comparto.
Okay, perfect.
Bye.
Wow.
My dream house is a beach house in San Blas. A house with a palm roof and a pool in front of the beach. A grill to make roasts and mango trees, Tommy. At night, make bonfires. At night, make bonfires and dance with my beloved wife, my favorite son, be my baby.
I love the part where you said your wife, right? And your baby. Okay, excellent job, Oscar. Okay, volunteers, guys, excellent. I like the idea. Okay, who continues? Do we have volunteers? Or Amilka and Oscar can choose. Okay, who says me?
Hugo Ayala.
Hugo Ayala, let's go, Hugo.
Help me the project picture in WhatsApp.
Okay, okay, I can. Let me just check, please. Is that the one that says Albo or is it Home Sweet Home?
Home Sweet Home.
Okay, got it. Okay, give me just a moment, okay. Okay, you can start, Hugo.
Yes. Speak about my dream house. My ideal dream house will be a house where I can live alone with my family. A beautiful balcony. Beautiful sofa, workplace, it must have a garden in which one can play or plant trees and enjoy it. Her room should be spacious and air fresh. For my family health, how do you say salud, health? Huh? Yes, teacher. Hello.
I'm sorry. Health.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's it, teacher.
Okay, very good, Hugo. Excellent. Thank you so much for presenting. Okay, guys, who is going to be the next one? Volunteers, guys. Volunteers. Okay. No volunteers, guys. No volunteers. Who says me? Okay, Vanessa or Beth. Let's go, Vanessa.
Okay. Ahorita.
Okay. Okay, everybody's going to participate, guys. So don't worry, everybody will have their time. Okay. Let's go, Vanessa.
My dream house is beach house. My dream home is a beach house. It's a small but cute, beautiful. Located in front of the sea, far away. Made of wood and sliding windows to see the sunrise right in front of a little dock made for me. Between palm the trees.
Okay, that's it. Oh, I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm. Four bedrooms, two upstairs, with conch pendants in a room. The
okay, thank you, Vanessa. Hello, Vanessa, did you finish? Terminamos? Okay, yes.
Finish.
Okay, thank you, Vanessa. Excellent job, thank you. Okay, the next one, guys, who is going to participate? Volunteers? Okay, let's go, Eloisa, thank you.
Okay, mm-hmm. My dream house is a villa in a quiet city. There is a big, oh, perdón, no compartirle.
I was going to ask you, but I said no, she's too inspired to do it. I didn't want to interrupt you. Okay, go ahead. Sure.
Okay. Ya pueden verla.
Yes.
Okay, bye. Mm-hmm. My dream house is a villa in a quiet city. There is a big pool. There are four rooms with a lot of windows. There is a big kitchen with glass door. It's very bright. And how do you pronounce comfortable?
Okay, it is comfortable or comfortable.
Okay, mm-hmm. It is very bright and comfortable. Is that?
Okay, excellent, Eloisa, very good, excellent. Okay, volunteers, guys, who else wants to continue?
Me, George.
Okay, let's go, George.
And give me one moment, compare the picture.
Share, okay, you're going to share.
Ta-da.
Let's go. Not yet. Is it in WhatsApp or here?
In WhatsApp.
Okay, give me just a moment, please.
Thank you.
Is that you?
Yes.
The picture?
It's me.
Okay, let's see.
My little dog.
Okay, your dogs. Do you have two dogs?
Four dogs.
Four. How can you handle that? ¿Cómo puede hacer eso, George? How can you do that?
I like getting dogs.
Okay, that's great. That's great. Okay, let's go, George. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Okay. And my dream home is a small villa with big window near the city with big garden and many trees, two rooms and a large kitchen and of course and one grill. I can not miss the una perezosa and two Siberian husky. That's it.
So cute, your dogs and house too, your husky's dog, right?
Right.
Okay, that's a very good dream, George.
Okay.
To have a lot of dogs in the garden and with the trees. Okay, thank you, George. Okay, another person, guys. Some of you are still missing who are going to present. Who says me?
Me.
Okay, Carlos. Let's go, Carlos. Do you have the picture? Are you going to share? Or do you want me to share?
Letting in WhatsApp.
Okay, it is in WhatsApp. Okay, let me check. The one from Gladiador, is okay. That you? No, Gladiador, no?
No.
Okay, C-A-B-M, is that yours?
C-A-B-M, sí.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's you. Gladiador. Who is Gladiador, guys, by the way?
Teacher, you don't have to forget that beautiful nickname.
Gladiador, okay. It is similar to you, right?
Very similar.
It looks like you, right? Give me just a moment. I'm going to share. Okay, let's see. Let's see qué pasa, okay? Se hace un mouse. Give me just a moment, guys. Se me ha perdido el. Okay, let's see. Okay, tengo problemas con la computadora, guys. Give me just a moment, okay? Okay, there it is.
Thank you. My dream house is very big, modern, in a small villa that has a terrace with a beautiful view, mm-hmm. and full of meeting with my family. also that it has many windows to be illuminated. That's it.
Okay. Okay, very good. Thank you, Carlos. When we say, for example, iluminada, Carlos, podemos decir, for example, the house is very lighted. Okay, lighted. Or bright también. Bright. Okay, we can say that. Thank you, Carlos. Okay,
thank you.
Okay, somebody else, guys? Somebody else who wants to present?
Teacher, Gladiador is going to participate.
Can you? Who is Gladiador? I don't see Gladiador.
Can you share the last picture in the group?
Sure, please? Sure, I can. Let's see. There
okay.
You.
Okay. As you can see, there that the last student said that different kind of house. But if you see the picture, and that you can see a different house. You know, well, I would like to have a smart house like that you can see in the picture. But the house had to be a smart house, you know, but had to be near to the nature. So far of the series, and the house had to have an individual room. Mm-hmm. And there had to be the kitchen room, living room, you know, but no small. That I would like to be medium, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the other thing that I had is the house had to be surrounded by different kind of animals,
mm-hmm.
but no dangerous animal. And the view has toward for the forest, mountains, lake, and I would like to be with my the house had to have some rayers, like let me see, the house had to make the difference, but you know it's very impossible to get this kind of house. But I would like to have this, but only maybe when I have a million, you know. That's it. Thank you for hearing me.
Okay, you're welcome. Okay, Naum, only one thing.
Okay.
Hello, Naum.
Okay.
Okay. For example, when you say the house has to.
Ah, okay. Okay.
Has
I forget.
To. Okay.
Okay. I'm going to. Okay. I'm going to worry in that.
Perfect.
Naum, okay. Is
perfect.
Naum.
Yes.
Naum. You have to invite me. The grill yes. Looks great.
Oh. Of course,
yes,
of
all
course.
Of us, all of us. You have to
maybe
invite
we are celebrate that green wing when we get the certificate of corporative English, you know.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Yeah, good idea.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Somebody else, guys, who wants to present? Do you want to present, guys? Okay. No volunteers. No. No? Okay, guys. Let's continue then. Entonces, vamos a continuar with this activity. So what we are going to do mainly is that I'm going to share with you a link where you're going to listen the video and the words that are missing. So I'm going to share this, the picture where you are going to work. And that means you are going to watch the video, this activity we have it before, but it's good to work the listening part. ¿Qué vamos a hacer, guys? Vamos a ver un video y vamos a completar la siguiente sección. ¿Ok? Hay algunas palabras que hacen falta, entonces esas son las que vamos a completar. Lo vamos a hacer in pairs y les comparto la worksheet. No sé si tengamos dudas, guys. questions acerca de la activity? No questions? No? Ok, entonces vámonos a los breakout rooms. Les comparto la tarea en el WhatsApp, el video y la worksheet, ok? Give me just a moment. Okay, it is in WhatsApp. You can go there. And here is the link. Okay, let's go to work in the breakout rooms. Okay, guys, si quieren les puedo dar ahorita para que vayamos a tomar agua, nos levantemos un ratito, guys, porque entiendo que la hora, el calor y el sueño a veces como que nos absorbe, ¿verdad? Así que levantémonos, tomemos agua y... ya casi, guys, almost, almost, okay? If you have a candy, right, you can eat it, water... Menos café, ¿verdad? Porque le va a quitar el sueño. Okay, so don't drink coffee now.
Delicious. Delicious, yes. Teacher. Delicious.
No te quita el sueño el café.
Yes. Usted tiene el café en la sangre, ¿verdad, Daily?
Teacher.
Yes.
A mí me sucedió algo con el café.
Ajá.
Antes tenía una adicción de que no podía... irme a dormir si no me bebía una taza de café antes de ir a acostarme.
¿Y podía dormir usted?
Después de tomarme el café, sí. Antes de tomarme el café no podía dormir.
Era como, era como que te estuviera arrullando el café.
Era la bebida milagrosa, ¿verdad?
Era como una, ¿cómo decirle? Como que fuera una pastilla para dormir, ¿ah? ¿Eh?
Mire.
Sí, tenía ese estaba en ese punto, ¿eh?
Sí, y no le causó como alguna consecuencia, alguna enfermedad.
No, simplemente había agarrado, era como una, ¿cómo lo puedo decir? Una mía, que es más, me daba insomnio no tomarme el café.
Sí,
a veces me despertaba a las 12 de la noche y tenía que tomarme el café para poder dormir tranquilo.
Pero ya no tiene ese hábito, ¿sí?
No, teacher.
Bueno, mejor, ¿verdad? Sí, es que el café a cierta edad afecta ya después, ¿verdad?
¿Qué dice?
Sí.
El café afecta, pero si usted lo deja mucho tiempo del que ya estuvo, de lo contrario, ¿no? No es dañino, es bueno.
Ok, guys. Escucho tantos expertos en esta clase que tengo que tomar notas aquí. Ok, guys, vamos entonces a los breakout rooms. Vamos a hacer en pareja. We watch the video and complete the worksheet. Ok, let's go. Okay, let's go, guys. Let's see, Jennifer, Walter, let's go, please. The breakout rooms. Amilcar, everything okay?
In pairs, teacher.
Yes, it's going to be in pairs. Okay, Amilcar?
I alone, teacher.
You are okay. I'm going to send you again to the breakout room. So please take care with the papa. Okay, let's go, Amilcar. Jennifer. Alejandra, how is everything going, ladies? Jennifer, Alejandra? What happened, Amilcar? ¿Qué pasó, Amilcar? Amilcar? Okay, maybe the internet is... not working. Okay, I'm gonna try to send you again. Okay, again. Let's try the last time, please, Amilcar. Hello, Emelina. Questions? How is everything going? ¿Cómo vamos, Emelina?
Good morning. I listen in the video now, chat.
Okay, questions?
No, not yet. I'm good right now.
Okay, let's continue. Let's continue, Emelina. Hello, Jessica, did you have problems? Hello, Jessica? Hola, hola, Jessica, are you there? Hello? Okay, let me know if you listen. Hello, Jessica? Hello, hello? Hello, Jennifer, Jessica, are you okay, ladies? Beverly? Jessica? Hello, hello.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, Jessica.
Sí, yo.
¿Qué pasó, Jessica?
Aquí, que mi audio no sirve bien.
Va, está bien, Jessica, no hay problema. Ahorita estamos trabajando en las actividades de WhatsApp. Si las puede, diga si las puede ver. Está una imagen y está un enlace. Eso es lo que vamos a hacer, es ver el video y completar las palabras que hacen falta. ¿Ok, Beverly?
Ok, teacher, ok.
Okay, perfect. Okay, the same, right, Jennifer? What about you know? What happened? Is it the same problem you have about with the internet?
Teacher, I don't know what happened, but I fixed my internet. Mm-hmm. Now I don't have problem with that, but when I have in a chat room that happened the same thing.
It happens the same thing. It's because the breakout room doesn't want you there, maybe.
Uh-huh. But that's why I have to work alone again.
Okay. Okay. But did you finish now? Did you finish?
Only the first part. Like I had like a answer.
Mm-hmm.
But I had to finish that activity.
Okay. Part. So we still have some minutes, you can finish that, okay?
Okay.
You sure?
Okay.
Okay. Hey, hello guys, did you finish?
No, teacher.
Not yet, okay. I'm gonna give you 2 minutes more, okay? I'm gonna mute myself.
Okay.
Okay, 2 minutes.
Hello?
Hello, did you finish?
Hello, regresamos. Ay, perdón.
Yes, did you finish, guys?
Finish,
yes.
Okay. Vamos a hacer algo, guys. Ya casi se nos acabó el tiempo.
Yes.
Yes, right. Y tenemos que hacer el quiz, right? Que hacemos daily. Entonces, voy a pedir que hagamos el quiz. Y el próximo lunes vamos a revisar el video. I'm going to pass the attendance in the meantime. Voy a pasar la asistencia mientras completamos el quiz. Okay, guys?
Okay.
No pude terminar con la
sesión. Okay, Amilcar. Yes, Amilcar. Hello, Amilcar. Okay, Angela. Angela. Angela, no. Let's see, Carlos Ademir. Carlos Ademir.
Present.
Okay, got it. Daily Lizeth.
Listen.
Okay, thank you. Daily Lizeth. Daily. Este día le se tiene que quedar. Oiga, los 10 minutos de refuerzo. Okay, thank you, Daily.
How often do you drink milk?
Okay, let's see. Eloisa.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Hugo?
Present. Okay. Hugo Castro, present. Okay,
thank you. I'm going to mention the ones that I didn't mention, the ones that were not in the class before, okay? Jessica Beverly?
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Jose Naum? No? Okay, let's see, Mabel Hernandez. Mabel. No. Okay, let's see, Emelina.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Naum Hernandez.
Present, teacher. Thank you.
You're welcome. Nancy Guadalupe. No. Oscar Armando. Oscar Armando.
Present, okay. Teacher.
Linda Vanessa.
Sí.
Ya terminé el curso.
Linda Vanessa, guys. No, no está. Ok. Jairo, no. Ok. Ok, guys, did you finish the quiz, by
sí,
the way?
Sí, me escuchó, teacher.
¿Sí? Oscar, permítame, Oscar.
Me escuchó.
No. Pero sí, sí. Ya tiene la
check. No hay mi nombre. O ya me había puesto.
Sí, ya le había puesto, pero sí, la clase. Uh-huh. Sí, Oscar.
Vale.
Ok. Ok, gracias. Guys, you're welcome. You're welcome. Did you finish, guys?
Yes.
Yes. Everybody?
Yes.
Todos, guys? Ok, todavía tenemos unos 3 minutos. ¿Está bien si continuamos con el video, guys? ¿Y compartimos las respuestas?
I have a question.
Yes, teacher. Tell me, George.
Uh-huh. In the section 2, uh-huh. again, in the middle term exam,
uh-huh.
Es para hacerlo el fin de semana o...
The middle term, I guess it is at the end. Creo que ese es para el final, that is at the end.
Two tests, teacher.
Do we have two tests?
Yes, middle term and the final exam.
Okay,
section 4.
Okay, si es así, guys. Okay, previously, guys, you had two tests. Is that
yes.
so? Okay,
yes.
So if you can complete
section
it.
Section 2 and the section 4.
Okay, antes, guys, no sé si teníamos el middle term, porque this is my first time. Entonces, no sé si antes ustedes hacían dos tests.
I don't know.
Sí, yes.
Sí.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Okay,
uno
guys.
A medio mes y el otro al final de mes.
Pero el de 4 partes, ese lo hacíamos el fin de semana, por lo menos con el mes anterior.
Ah, bueno. Bueno, si tenemos tiempo para...
Ahorita solo hemos hecho el de 4 preguntas.
Sí, aquí lo estoy viendo. El midterm, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Yes, fin de semana.
The another one is the section 4. Final exam.
Ok. Ok, entonces si podemos completarlo.
¿Nos tocaría entonces, teacher?
Sí, quizás nos tocaría. No estoy muy segura. Pero si podemos completarlo, guys, hagámoslo. Ok.
En la anterior, en el módulo anterior, es el mirror test, lo hicimos en el fin de semana.
Vale, está bien. Bueno, si podemos el fin de semana, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Okay.
I understand. Okay. Perfect.
Yes, weekend.
Okay, in the weekend, entonces.
Bye.
Okay, guys, bye. Have a good night.
Good night.
Ya nos despidió a Milka, así que let's go.
Lo salvé con las preguntas, señores. Así
see
que
you Monday.
Vamos a descansar.
Okay, good night. Have a great weekend. Good night, guys. We can go
good night, guys.
Right? Bye-bye, Oscar. See
let's
you.
Let's go to party.
Thank you, guys. See you.
See you. Have a nice night. Weekend. Ok, nos quedamos daily entonces. Sí, Alejandra. Aquí está Alejandra. Ok. Let's go. Okay, let's see. Okay, let's see. No, hola, Daily. Okay, ahí está. Okay, Daily, no sé si tiene alguna duda, algún tema que quiere que reforcemos. ¿O cómo se ha sentido en la clase?
Fíjese de que la verdad,
bueno, al principio sí, quizás hasta ya ni me había conectado los primeros días, porque, o sea, yo veo que casi, no es culpa suya ni nada por el estilo, sino que yo veo que los que ya están ahí como que ya mastican bien el inglés, ya ellos saben el inglés y ellos ya entienden. En cambio, yo, cada vez que me meto a un curso de inglés,
sí,
como que me siento yo mal que lo voy a atrasar si yo estoy ahí. Ahí voy más o menos, pero sí, como le digo, me cuesta porque yo nunca me vi, yo creo que ellos ya han recibido cursos de inglés, ya han estado un módulo más alto, entonces yo no, primera vez que lo recibo un módulo así, que me meto así intenso al inglés, y pues ya, el inglés siempre fue algo que a mí se me dificultaba bastante, pero sí le voy entendiendo ahí un poquito.
¿Y cómo se ha sentido? Por ejemplo, con los temas, ¿los has sentido difíciles?
Piensa de que en sí los temas, cuando usted los explica, el problema es que casi no conozco palabras. No conozco verbo, no me los puedo, pues.
Sí.
Entonces, no porque sí le entiendo que usted me explica y me dice que el verbo aquí o lo que usted está explicando. Yo lo entiendo, lo único que no le puedo dar más oraciones porque, como le digo, no conozco muchas palabras, tengo que estudiar palabras para poder, pero sí le entiendo, cabal, a su clase le entiendo.
Ah, vaya, fíjese que en ese caso, lo que más podemos hacer es como reforzar palabras, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, verbos, así que poco a poco existen aplicaciones donde podemos ir poco a poco, ¿verdad? Entonces no se sienta así, porque es normal, ¿verdad? Es normal. Eso es normal, así que eso es poco a poco, Daily, eso es poco a poco. Ok, entonces no, está bastante bien, la verdad que la felicito porque está participando, yo la veo que participo, fíjese.
Allí trato la manera de,
sí,
de ir, y lo que estoy haciendo es que estoy en Duolingo, creo que se llama, y Lingo, practico y se aprende bastante, porque sí he aprendido bastantes palabras ahí, ya, entonces creo que eso me ha ayudado un poquito más ya, porque sí, estaba en inglés yo estaba perdida.
Sí.
Ya hoy más o menos, yo ya voy.
Ya mastica.
Ya lo mastico, ya hoy a veces oigo palabras o ya se me quedaron bastante. Entonces, pero sí, su clase, le digo que para mí, y a veces, o sea, yo digo que a veces, ayer que se preguntó, o sea, muchos dicen que hablen más inglés, pero, o sea, porque ellos, yo creo que ya están un poquito más avanzados, siento yo que ya están en un mundo más avanzados, y con señora de las que estamos ahí, no, las dos estamos iguales, que andamos algo perdiditas ahí, le digo, pero dice ella que todavía agarra otras palabras.
No, pero mire, si tiene dudas o cualquier cosa, no importa, oiga, estamos para aprender, ¿verdad? ¿Ok? Así que si usted tiene dudas de la clase, usted pregunte, ¿ok? Entonces, reforcemos si quiere algún tema que necesite, que tenga dudas, que, por ejemplo, no podemos hacer algunos ejercicios, por ejemplo. No sé si tenga alguna duda de algún tema, Daily.
Fíjese que tal vez podemos reforzar el creo que el lunes me tocaba quedarme a mí y no la recibí. No sé de qué fue lo que habló el lunes. Tal vez por ahí reforzar un poquito lo del lunes.
Vaya, no, el lunes estuvimos viendo, permítame, la reviso porque no me recuerdo que estuvimos viendo el lunes.
Yo empecé a ver la clase, pero no la terminé porque cuando me quedo, me gusta verla ahí, la clase.
Ah, sí, sí. Fíjese que ese día vimos los adverbios de frecuencia, frequency adverbs. Entonces, ya, ahorita. Entonces, los frequency adverbs. Frequency adverbs. Estuvimos viendo algunos. Por ejemplo, vimos sometimes, que significa algunas veces. Vimos también el adverbio always, que significa siempre. Vimos también el adverbio never, nunca. Vimos también otro que es el often, que significa también algunas veces, ¿verdad? Entonces estuvimos viendo como el lugar en la oración de los frequency adverbs. Ok, por ejemplo, ¿Qué es algo que usted siempre hace, David? ¿Qué es algo que usted siempre hace?
Bañarme.
Ok, entonces sería I always. El verbo bañar es take a shower. Yo siempre me baño, ¿a qué hora? At.
A las 6.
A las 6 a.m. Okay. Yo siempre me baño a las 6 a.m. Ahora, ¿qué es algo que usted, por ejemplo, hace algunas veces?
Algunas veces. Quiero ver.
¿Qué es lo que hace algunas veces? Por ejemplo, visitar a su familia.
Ir a pasear.
Ir a pasear, exacto. O ir al cine, ¿verdad? Entonces, sometimes go to the cinema. ¿Ok? Entonces, algo que nunca hace, David. ¿Qué es algo que usted nunca hace, digamos?
Salir a tomar.
I never. Entonces sería I never drink alcohol. Alcohol. I never drink alcohol. Entonces, si se fijan en estas oraciones, el adverbio de frecuencia va en medio del sujeto, I, y en medio del verbo.
Del verbo, ajá.
Pero también lo podemos utilizar al principio de las oraciones. Por ejemplo, let's see, sometimes, en el caso de sometimes, eso solo pasa con sometimes, I go to the church, digamos, algunas veces. Voy a la iglesia. Eso solo lo podemos hacer con el sometimes.
Solo con el sometimes.
Sometimes I go to church. Entonces, esas son como las dos posiciones de los adverbios, ¿verdad? En el caso de sometimes, lo podemos utilizar al principio y en medio del sujeto y el verbo, ¿ok? Ok, básicamente eso fue lo que vimos, Daily, los adverbs of frequency. También vimos las preguntas, estuvimos viendo las preguntas. Por ejemplo, do you always take a shower at 6 a.m.? Do you always take a shower at 6 a.m.? ¿Siempre te bañas a las 6 de la mañana? Y ese tipo de respuesta lo vamos a responder con yes, I do, sí, sí lo hago. O también podemos decir no, I don't.
Con yes, I do.
Yes, I do. O no, I don't.
No, I don't.
Y si se fija, el adverbio va en medio del sujeto y el verbo, ¿ok? Ok, eso fue básicamente lo que hemos estudiado, David. No sé si tengo alguna otra duda, eso fue lo que vimos el día lunes.
Las preguntas siempre van a ir con do you o también va a ir, depende el sujeto, ¿verdad?
Exacto, depende del sujeto. Por ejemplo, si estamos hablando de he, she o it, vamos a utilizar does. Does she always... Y el resto de más, ¿verdad? Take a shower in the morning. Sería, yes, she does, o no, she doesn't. Entonces, ese sería más que todo la clase, Daily. Si, por ejemplo, hay alguien que no se quede, sí me gustaría quedarme con usted. Por ejemplo, hay algunos que se les olvida. Entonces, sí me gustaría darle como más... quizás más con los temas, porque a veces entramos tarde o pasa algo, ¿verdad? El internet y perdemos el hilo, ¿verdad?
Sí, correcto.
Entonces sí me gustaría, si le parece, para que podamos reforzar siempre los temas.
Ah, vaya, está bien. Muchas gracias.
Vaya, Deli, no le quito su sueño porque si no, el café lo va a pagar.
Muchas gracias, teacher.
Vaya. Descanse y nos vemos mañana. Good night, David.
El lunes.
Perdón. Ya mucho café.
Sí, nah, el café le ayuda para la memoria.
Sí, ayuda, pero ya veo que usted lo tiene en la sangre.
Sí.
Okay, daily, have a good night.